Okay, everyone, here it is. I'll be covering the Transformers movie Voyager Thundercracker. He is a repaint of the Starscream figure, which at first made me go, oh, that's nice. But after seeing it in person, I kind of like it. The color looks a little nice. I actually watched a little bit of my Starscream video, and I'm hoping that over time my video's quality has improved. I can't watch my videos. I get bored watching them, so I don't know how you guys do it. But here we go. Thundercracker. He's like Starscream. He's an F-22 Raptor. Kind of bulky. These parts seem how it's going to stand out. Color's a little more. I think the color kind of helps the figure a lot. I'm actually considering getting G1 Starscream repaint. If maybe once I see it in person, because the color does seem to improve the figure. Again, I have turned the head around, so it's not as visible. I love this song. Looks kind of more like maybe a thruster, perhaps. You know. Quick comparison. Here is a regular Star... Well, not regular Starscream, but here's Starscream. Let's give you kind of a show how the colors are different for these figures. Okay. So, let's get out of the way. Also note the missiles. I did not have them put in. This is a Thundercracker's missile. That's Starscream. So the missiles fit their colors a little differently. Now, I'm not going to put them in because, as I mentioned before, I do not like the missile idea. But ever since the first video, I've learned that actually, this little tab here, I never saw that before. When you flick that, it may still roll. No, it doesn't roll, but the trigger for the missiles don't activate pretty much. It blocks them. So you can actually pose this and not have the missiles going off every time you move the figure. Just kind of handy. I like that. Cause see when they turn. I'm gonna leave it there. See when they spin, they hit it right there, and that's what fires it. So let's transform it. Hopefully this will be a little better than before. Hopefully I'm a little more experienced with this figure. I'm not going to fast forward through it, so that's a plus, right? If you have Starscream, this will be just, a piece of cake for you. Unless you gotta bend up knees. Yeah. And I've also found that maybe I mentioned my Starscream, how the legs come out of there pretty easily. I think that's maybe just that figure, because this one, the joints in there, they're in there really snug. They don't come out at all. I think most of my experiences, the figures are just from, defective ones. And note for the wings, I didn't know this before either. When you're putting the wings in, you have to put them in the top, and then clip them in place there. Otherwise, when you put them in, see they just kind of pop out. You have to push them in and then push them down. They click in place. I didn't know that before. I've learned so much since I made that first video. Alright. And then you gotta kind of force that in because the peg in there is a little big. But hey, it works. Okay. Go ahead and spin the head around. Now the way I do this is I turn these down first. Like that. I turn the flaps down. Not flaps, fins, I guess. I spin these inwards so you have easier clearance. And then when I start pulling them up, I get them out there, spins, turn, spin like that, and then like that. It's so easy to do. And also, before I didn't know this, when you're pushing this in, make sure this goes as far as possible. Because these have a peg in them that actually, see that little peg there? See that? There's a hole in the wings, and those actually clip in place there. Once again, I did not know that originally. And when I transform it, the sections in the back wouldn't really lock in place, and they wouldn't look right. They'd look weird. So fold those down. These you kind of, I think they're supposed to be like that. Kind of looks okay. Fold up the shoulders, the arms down. And then you get this section back. Make sure you fold this part down. When that peg locks in there, And you have Thundercracker.
I like it.
I believe it's supposed to be for the legs. Supposed to, I think, bend this section back. And then bend that forward a little bit. I heard that that's the way he stands in the movie. I haven't commented. I haven't used this before. You know, something like that. See how his legs are? Which I think that actually kind of helps a little bit. Because, you know, his lower body isn't really all that great.
Yeah.
Top looks pretty good. I've grown to actually like the top.
Give me a second. I will bump this up slightly. All right.
I've grown to like the top section of the Starscream Thundercracker mold. Oh, forgot. You gotta pull these out, too.
I don't want to leave something out, don't I? Yeah.
Alright, so. Now he's complete. Aside from his missiles, which I like missiles. I still don't like, you know, the hands thing. I wish he had them. But I'm growing to like it. He's really not that bad of a figure. And here's a quick comparison. I mentioned how I like Thundercracker a lot more than Starscream. I don't know if it's the color, really. The color does help, I think, which is, I'm really considering the G1 Starscream. But I think it's actually the head, too. Okay, here's the head on Starscream, okay? Really alien, you know, it's... The one thing the movie that people really didn't like is that all the heads, all the faces looked really alien. Okay? Here's the head on Thundercracker. It's alien, yeah, but this actually looks more Transformer-ish to me than, oh, great. Catfighting. But, yeah, it looks a little more Transformer-ish than other stuff. I like it, actually. So, here you go. There's both of them. Standing in, you know, correct poses. I'll put a missile in for you to show how those were, in case you forgot. Okay, so there's that missile. Here's that one. There you go. Transformers the movie, Voyager, Thundercracker, with a guest appearance by Starscream. I'm gonna admit, if they do have another remold of the figure, or a repaint, rather, and if there's a different head, I may consider getting it, because this one really grew on me. Now, I saw the pictures before when it was originally released, it was being released, and I wasn't really too fond of it. I thought, just, you know, repaint with a new head, that's not going to work at all. But the color just looks really good. I mean, look at that head, though, that's nice. And, of course, you know, the orange for the light pipe in the back. There's a view of the back for you. Alright. There you go. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a good one.